Because you are afraid. Because we do not want ourselves to think that we do not know. We want to come to quick conclusions and tell ourselves, oh, I know. Uncertainty threatens us. That's why we feel a tremendous need to keep proclaiming that I know. So you see someone, he's coming. Of course you know nothing about him. But if you admit to yourself that you know nothing, then you run the risk of being called ignorant in your own eyes. And the ego hates that. The ego is so ignorant that it cannot tolerate to be called ignorant. So the moment you come across something, you start feeling a certain pressure to bring it within your domain of knowledge, to declare to yourself that you know. Have you seen how frequently people use this expression? I know, I know, I know. Try telling something to somebody and see how this expression pops up 10 times within 30 seconds. No, no, don't tell me, I already know. It is because we are very insecure, very afraid. Very, very afraid. Knowing is one's nature. And the ego is far away from nature. It does not know anything. And when you do not know anything, then you need to wear the facade of knowledge. You cannot say that I know that I do not know. When you want to say that you know, you need to have something tangible in your hands, right? So you conclude. You conclude without any basis. Have you seen how people form opinions? Somebody's face resembles somebody else's face. And very quickly the mind concludes that this person must be having the same personality traits. Have you seen that happen? In fact, somebody's name reminds you of somebody, you start forming an opinion about this person just on the basis of his name. We have a terrible need to conclude. But the wise man is all right remaining in uncertainty. He can humbly and cheerfully accept that he does not know. The fool hates to admit that he does not know. The wise man relishes it. So the next time you feel like quickly forming an opinion or quickly closing the matter, don't we say, let's shut down the matter, let's come to a conclusion. Have you heard people talking like, let's not discuss any further, let's conclude. Often, at the end of my talk, people would come up and say, so can we know in just one line what was the gist of the entire 2 hours? This is the fool's way of knowing, coming to a conclusion. No, no, you keep the whole 2 hours aside. Tell me in a nutshell. If it could be told in a nutshell, were we idiots to spend 2 hours? And often, if you say something which may have great beauty, great poetry, great significance in it, but no conclusion, then the fellow will say, all right, but so what? Have you heard such things? You have talked your heart out, and the other person is saying, all right, but so what? This is the need to come to a conclusion. Don't be in a hurry to conclude. Let life remain an open chapter, because conclusion means ending, and ending is death. Life is not a conclusion. It's a continuous movement from page to page. It's a flow. The river never really concludes. And when it does, then it sublimates into the sea. It's gone. Don't ask for early conclusions. Early conclusions are like abortions. They will kill life. So what did you conclude from what is?
Does that we should not come to a...
Don't break my heart. Please sit down. One thing that we and Dushan are now clear upon is that this time from India, he will not take back anything. Chadakarir ke liye, I requested him, kindly forget Prashant totally when you leave India. Because all that he can carry back is conclusions. If he has lived fully here with me, then why does he need to conclude? Why does he need to say that this is what I learned? If you have really learned, then how will you remember what you have learned? Don't take back anything. Don't conclude. Go back empty-handed. Then you are really rich.